Welcome to aonlinetraining.com.
Hi, in this software I teach you paint color effect on sketch layout of fashion designing in Photoshop. This is I'll show you the example on the internet how the fashion design sketch layout to be painted in Photoshop. So this is I'm taking the sketch. So I'm just go to open from my source. This is my file to open it. So I just opened this file. Now this is a swatch palette. This palette you can take in window menu, and now I'm working on the layer palette. So I work on paint as on the new layer. So I just go layer menu and new. So this is how you can create a new layer, and I just put it down over there, and my sketch is above, and the blending mode should be multiply. Then I'm just going to select my skin colors to paint it in Photoshop. So I go my brush tool, brush property, wet media brush. So this is a pen, and this you show you the watercolor effect in Photoshop. So I go with the brush tool, and you can increase the brush size by pressing start bracket and end bracket, just left side from the starting P keys on keyboard. So this is how you can paint it. Wet paint brush effects, like one side if you go over the paint and you go from other side to be first side, it give you the dark shade. So I just paint on the sketch legs over there, taking the skin colors from swatches. As I told that swatches I take from the window menus. All the palettes are showing coming in window menu. I just paint it over this legs, and you have to be keep in mind, this is looking very flat color, so I have to be just make the shades of that to give that depth of that legs or the whole model which I paint. So I just go for the dark shades or the going to over paint from the wet paint to give a depth of or the side shadows of the legs and other dress also. Just going to same color, same brush from the left to other side. See, I just go for the overlapping, see, give you the shades or give you the depth of that paint color. Same from the other part also. Very precisely you have to do to make the shadows or the depth of the object. Don't worry, just that paint is overall on the dress side area also, another side also. We have to just erase that after the final. So you have to freely to paint on this different area of the section. So I'm going to the neck and the arms, the with the skin colors. So paint it with skin color. Increase the size of the brush. From there, you can increase the size of the brush. I'll just cover up this whole area of the skin section, so that's why I increase the size. This is you can paint the arms area also, and the neck and the chest also. I'm just give the all a depth shade from the all sides. This is from the shadows of the dress between the chest. I'll just go for the face paint. I just give you the side chin area shades, so it's give you the better look of the face and the overall the paint effects. So I need to be some more shades. So I go with the dark skin shades, then I give other shades of the dab shades on it. For dark shade, after this steps I will tell you next step in this video. So let's do complete this step. Come to the hair part area, so I go for the black color and reduce the size of the brush, so it's give you the thinner outlines related to your hair, that hairs. So I just make more strokes from the brush for the hairs, so it's perform like more details on the hairs also. So I'm just painting. And you have to be paint according to the directions of that hairstyles. So you need to be more and more paints. So it's give you the more hairstyles. After this steps, I will tell you next step in this video. So let's do complete this step. I go for other shades. So I want something like, you know, light shade on the hair, so I'll just go the white color, so give the white stroke to also, so it's perform that lighten shades on the hairs, so it's give you the more detailings in the hairs part. So still I'm working on that black strokes to cover that all the curly hairs on this. So yes, work on the curly hairs, just roll around the hairs, so it's give you the better styles of the hairs, which is already in the sketch also. So let's white shade, white color, yeah, select the white color or the light grayish color. So same on this, in between of the black I just outline the more strokes, so it's give you more in-depth detailed shades. So I don't want to be a like plain outlines of the black. So this step you can follow one or two times to give you more details inside the hairs. After this steps I will tell you next step in this video. So let's do complete this step. then I go for the earrings. So I've select, you can go for any colors, but I select the reddish or white between that. I go for the oranges kind of. So it's depend like which color you want to suits on your jewelries also. So I just simply to paint as solid color with that earring with the orange. Precisely you have to paint. Again I repeat, work on reduce the size or increase the size of the brush according the base of zoom and zoom out. Because if there is a small area, so you need to be zoom in, control plus, and adjust the size of brush by going the brush property or start bracket or end brackets with this below with the plus sign in keyboard. It's near about the P keys. Then I zoom it, control plus, to work on the other color shades related to the dress. I simply to give this plain color as well as the shading on the dress. So I just painted. After this steps, I will tell you next step in this video. So let's do complete this step. So I still am painting and define the light shade from the dark shade of this blue dress. Now go for the light shade. Yes, I'm just going from the other side of the dress. After this steps, I will tell you next step in this video. So let's do complete this step. Now it's okay, but I want to be more dark color of this dress. So I just take the little bit dark color of this blue, so puffing my more contrast dress on the skin. Yeah, you can choose your colors. It's not be the same color you want to paint, but you should to be remember the shades, the shadows area, which is only to want to be paint on by the brush. So whatever the color you have choose, take that colors and go for the light shade, which you can get in swatches already. Then I'll go for the Gaussian blur filter, but you have to be select the particular layer. So I have told you the sketch is in other layer, skin color is another layer, and dress layer is another layer. So I've work on the dress. Now working with the skin, go in filter menu, or you can just apply filter, then blur, then Gaussian blur. Why I'm just doing the Gaussian blur? Because I performing that dark and light shade. So I just want to be that make the most soft and smooth, so it's look more fine. That's why I'm doing this filter effect on the separate layers. So now I'm just going to performing that eraser tool. So this is magic erasers. If you perform the solid color and it is remove as you see in sketch color, but I'm just go back and go to the another layer. Exactly, you can go for this click with control on this blank thumbnail of this layer, so it's give you the auto selection. I'm just telling because just for the knowledge. Now go back to my dress layer and I go for the eraser. So whatever this outflow of that color which I paint from that the sketch edge from the edge, so I just want to take from the brush the soft edge of the brush, then I go for remove it. Or you can, I just work on weight paint brush. So zoom in and precisely you can move easily. So remove from the eraser. We just zoom in control plus because we can see the more space area of the edge and the overflow of that color. So according to that we can paint, or we can after that we can just remove it. Undo, control Z. After this steps I will tell you next step in this video. So let's to complete this step. going to go for the dark shade, little bit the skin color which I have on chest. So I just want to be make give you the more cleavage. So I am just performing the cleavage. So according to the dress, it's look nice. So same dark shade of the color. So you just paint from the side, so it give you the cleavage effect. So if you are doing like painting, you should to be work on details, so your work will be like performing the best part. So while painting, it's not like select the color and just paint it. You have to work on each and everything, like shadings and then in depth of also with work whatever you're just going. I'm not erasing, I'm just select because make it the surround. So I go for the light shade and just do that. So now it's look nice. You can just go more effect of the light shade. After all, just paint undo. Control Z for undo. Now to go for similar shades. And just from the edge to be this thing. Now you go for the skin color eraser, so you have to be removed according to that. So you have to be keep work on that overflow edge to be removed. After this steps, I will tell you next step in this video. So let's to complete this step. So precisely is to work on this hand paint effect also with the lag also. You need to be more patient to this paint effect workout. So don't lose your patience, because you have to doing a nice work on the fashion layout sketch. Whatever you do last on sketch on paper and take the colors, give the paint effect on the papers. But this is what we call a digital paint painting effect. So it's give you the more you can on the paper when you paint, it doesn't have go back, but in digitally you can go back and you make the correction. So I make my additional point to work on the skin layer, last layer, and to add the color for my the shoes. I go for this red color to be paint over there. You can define more color paints. So fill that all the area of like whatever the colors you want, and I just fill that upper part of this shoe. So I just keep the same color as red. Now after that I'm going to select the erase, so go for it. So before I just complete the all two shoes with the same color effect. So I have to be keep in mind to work on the same shades of the colors, so it's look you the rhythm form. Now go for the eraser, same size, or you can increase the size, control that, sorry, bracket the side from the P keys in the keyboard. After this steps, I will tell you next step in this video. So let's to complete this step. Now for the hairs, after all removing that outer range off, I'm going to hair working. So I want more details or in depth, because the hair come like needs more outline, more strokes to be there. So I cover from the around the strokes, just decrease the size of the brush. I'll just repeat my that stroke and the style according to the style, whatever I keep it in sketch. So I just work on the black color, so it give you more stroke and depth, more coverage of the stroke. So after you have complete, go to file and save as. You have keep in mind, save your file, because you do the hard work for you performing a better effects. And the Photoshop file format is PSD, so you already keep in mind the source file will be PSD. Now you can merge all. I just merge with skin and the dress, like merge down. And yes, there is something left about the hand. So from the bottom it's just narrow, and then after that it's supposed to be broad, the hair hand. So see how you have to work on in depth on that. So you all work after that work, it look nice because you're working in depth. I hope you can understand, you understand the method according to the paint you have to work on for a shot. Now I'm going to I already created that the last layer, that is layer 2. It just because to make a background. Yeah, I select the color and go to the brush and make the nice background.
For queries, please contact us on info@aonlinetraining.com.